The U.S. and Ukraine are facing calls to refocus mutual relations from foreign aid to a full-scale diplomatic partnership amid an ongoing impeachment standoff. Here's one of America's Kristian Rouz to explain.
We're on the edge of the European frontier. Talk about how we can provide continued support to the Ukrainian people.
Secretary of State Mike Pompeo arrives in Ukraine to address Kyiv's latest calls to reshape bilateral relations. Talking about his visit Thursday, Pompeo stressed he is working to increase America's diplomatic support for Ukraine amid its challenging talks with the Kremlin to end the war that is entering its sixth year. And while U.S.-Ukrainian relations are changing, Democrat lawmakers continue to center their case for impeachment around foreign aid.
We promised Ukraine in 2014 that if they gave up their nuclear arsenal, that we would be there for them, that we would defend them.
Quid pro quo, I won't give Ukraine the money they need to fight you on the front line.
But President Volodymyr Zelensky of Ukraine says his country is more fiscally sustainable now, making U.S. foreign aid less important. In addition, the Javelin missiles provided by President Trump were actually sold, not gifted, to Ukraine, which paid $39 million of its own money for it. In this light, there are mounting calls both in Kyiv and in Washington to end the problematic U.S. aid for Ukraine, and other countries for that matter.
President Obama paused foreign aid twice, once to the Egyptians, and he never gave the military aid to the Ukrainians. He also gave aid to al-Sisi, a general who took over Egypt in a military coup. All of these things, I think, were against the will of Congress.
Back in 2002, the American Economic Review released a study saying every release in U.S. aid sparks an immediate increase in corruption in the recipient country. But the scheme is far more complex than mere misappropriation of aid upon receipt. The latest Burisma scandal in Ukraine saw oligarch Mykola Zlochevsky, a former Yanukovych minister, move tens of billions of dollars from Ukraine through offshores into the U.S. But when Zlochevsky was faced with a domestic investigation, Vice President Joe Biden used U.S. foreign aid to pressure Ukraine to end that probe and keep the corruption scheme going.
Not only the corruption of the Bidens, and I think Hunter Biden making $1 million a year while his dad's getting the prosecutor fired, does rise to the level of corruption, but he was also concerned with general corruption.
Pompeo says his visit in Ukraine will seek a normalization in relations with Russia as well. The secretary believes Moscow and Washington could work on nuclear non-proliferation and anti-terrorism, while working with Ukraine could deal a deadly blow to financial crime in Europe.
We're mindful of that. We're trying to find places. We work with the Russians. We're mindful how to deliver security and safety to Europe and to the world.
It remains to be seen if Pompeo reaches a breakthrough in Ukraine relations, as the nation is increasing outreach to the EU and Israel as well, among its other partners. In the meantime, the war in eastern Ukraine and the impeachment battle in Washington continue. Kristian Rouz, One America News.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.